Hi folks, Cal here. Well, the news is remembering George Herbert Walker Bush this week, so I thought I would take a few moments to remember him myself, as I do as I live through those times. I recall this George Herbert Walker Bush when he was running for president.
I'm the one who will not raise taxes. My opponent... My opponent now says he'll raise them as a last resort or a third resort. But when a politician talks like that, you know that's one resort he'll be checking into. And I... My opponent won't rule out raising taxes, but I will, and the Congress will push me to raise taxes, and I'll say no. And they'll push, and I'll say no. And they'll push again, and I'll say to them, read my lips. No new taxes.
Yep. Stood right there and said, no new taxes. Read my lips. And then, not long after being president, becoming president, and winning the election, he raised taxes through the roof. And what's worse, he was out jogging a few days later, and he was asked, yelled at by a reporter about what he'd done and about his promise to read his lips and not raise taxes. And he said in a smart-ass way, read my hips. This bastard had the gall to lie to the American people to get elected, to turn his backs on them, to betray them, and then make a snide remark about it. I recall the George Bush who gave a speech to the NRA. He pounded the podium and said, I will not ban guns. And very shortly after he got elected, he went right ahead and put through the biggest gun ban this country has ever seen. Through executive order, he banned the importation of every decent semi-automatic rifle that was at that time allowed for purchase in this country. But they're all banned from importation thanks to George Herbert Walker Bush. He betrayed the Constitution, he betrayed the people, he betrayed his oath of office. He was a globalist and an elitist who did a lot of what he did to help him and his millionaire and billionaire friends, and got quite wealthy by doing so, by the way. He got us involved in that stupid, ridiculous war defending Kuwait, who were slant drilling, by the way, into Iraq to steal their oil, and got attacked by Iraq because of it. And I don't care who, one way or the other, I don't care about Iraq, I don't care about Kuwait, but we got involved in that, spent, what, $1 billion or $2 on that nonsense, defending people who had literally had solid gold fixtures in their castles and in their palaces, who didn't pay us a nickel in return or give us free oil or anything. And the people who are American citizens who were injured in that war and are killed, did their families get anything out of Kuwait? Did Kuwait give them money to compensate them? No, they didn't. But I bet you a good old Bush and his family got sweetheart deals from the oil ministers of these countries after that, and they made themselves very rich. George Bush also completely supported the third world invasion of our country, bringing in and helping bring in hundreds of thousands and millions of third worlders here, which is destroying this country. Part of his globalist agenda. He was a traitor to our Constitution. He was a traitor to the people. He was a traitor to his country and the Republic, and he's a scumbag. And that's what he really was. Just because he liked his dog and liked to go fishing and he was an old man when he died doesn't mean he was a good person. And I think if we're going to really remember George Bush, let's remember the real George Bush and the crap he did. Because you know what? Human beings aren't whether they like dogs or not or like their grandkids. They're their actions. And his actions were deplorable. He betrayed this country. He betrayed the people who voted for him. He betrayed the Constitution. That's who he really was. Well, that's it, folks. That's the word for the day. Hey, listen, please subscribe. Click the little bell if you would, please. Check my Patreon below and share the video if you would so others may be here about the real George Bush. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.